an honor and a privilege this week to have my brother Aaron and his wife Rachel and baby Othniel. Amen. I'm more glad to have Othniel here than either of them, but it's just good to have this beautiful family, wonderful family in service with us this morning. Aaron's going to be coming, bringing forth the word. Remember, this morning, tonight, and then tonight at 5, and then Monday through Wednesday, it'll be at 7 o'clock. But Aaron, come on and have your liberty. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Isn't the Lord good this morning?
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I want to sing a song this morning. It's in your book. It's on 291. Ooh. Praise the Lord. You probably all heard it, maybe once or twice today, but let this be our prayer this morning. Revive us again.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Verse 34, he said, where have you laid him?
They said unto him, Lord, come and see. Jesus wept, and then said the Jews, behold how he loved him. And some of them said, could not this man, which opened the eyes of the blind, have caused that even this man should not have died? Jesus therefore again groaning in himself come into the grave, and it was a cave, and a stone lay upon it. Jesus said, take ye away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, saith unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he hath been dead for 4 days. Jesus saith unto her, said I not unto thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? And then they took away the stone from that place where the dead was laid, and Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hearest me, and I know that thou hearest me always. But because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. When he had thus spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face was bound about with a napkin. And Jesus said unto them, loose him, and let him go. And then many of the Jews which came to Mary and had seen the things which Jesus did, believed on him. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This morning, I want to preach this on a simple thought of, do you hear his voice? Hallelujah. Do you hear his voice? Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come before you, God, tonight, asking you and move in our hearts and our lives. Stir us, God, by your mighty word. Touch us, God. Lord, anoint us, God, to preach your word, God. Open up our ears and our hearts to receive you, God, as we gather around these altars here. In a few short moments, God, have your way, God. Minister, touch, fill with the Holy Ghost. Bless, encourage, God. Moved by your mighty hand, we pray in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I like that in verse 43. And when he had thus spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad that God is still talking to his children? Aren't you glad that God, he's still talking in the hearts and talking in the ears of his people? You might say, well, I've never heard the voice of God. And I tell you, open up your ears. He's talking to you this morning. Open up your heart. He's talking to you this morning. You'll find in the book of Revelation, it starts out, that book that Jesus, he's talking. And he says, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. Can I tell you, I don't understand it completely. I might not be a Bible scholar, but I do know this. God, he talks to his children. Hallelujah. I say, God, he talks to his children. Can I tell you, he's talking to the sinner this morning. I said, he's talking to the sinner this morning. He's saying, why don't you get saved? He's saying, why don't you give your heart to me? He's saying, why don't you surrender your life unto me? You know what the problem is with a lot of people? It seems like, everybody else, we hear their voice, but we don't hear God. Have you believed that God is the answer? Hallelujah. Have you believed Jesus is still the answer to every single problem that we face? Our problem is we find the answer, in our own self. We find the answer, we think it's the answer in our own goals, in our own ways, in our own religion. Can I tell you, religion, it might have helped us on the surface, but religion can't help you on the inside. What are you talking about? I'm talking about you must have the answer, Jesus Christ, on the inside of you. And I tell you, sinner, this morning, God's talking to you. I said, sinner, this morning, God is talking to you. The Bible said, that Jesus Christ, he shows up here. The Bible says that his friend Lazarus, he was, Jesus' friend. You'll find in often places in the Word of God where Jesus and Lazarus are by each other. You'll find, in the next chapter that Jesus and Lazarus, they're eating dinner together. They were friends. How he loved this man named Lazarus. But the Bible says Jesus shows up. And most of us, we know the story. But you know what? He shows up in the eyes of the natural 4 days late. In the eyes of everybody else, he showed up 4 days late. The Bible says that Martha ran out to meet him. She heard that Jesus was coming. And the Bible says, she said, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother would have not died. How do you know she was right? How do you know Jesus was there? He wouldn't have died. But how do you know Jesus had everything under control? The Bible says that Mary, she come. Because Martha comes to her and says, hey, the master calls for thee. Aren't you glad God's still calling after you this morning? I'm glad that God is still calling were both right. If Jesus was there, none of us would have probably died. But I come to tell you this, Jesus had everything under control.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Jesus shows up. He says, where have you laid him? Hallelujah. In all honesty, Jesus knew exactly where Lazarus was buried. In all honesty, Jesus knew exactly where. Oh, this dead corpse had been laying for 4 days. Oh, but Jesus said, oh, take me to the place, oh, where he lays. Take me to the grave. And I tell you, so many times the Lord, he knows what we're going through. He knows our struggles. He knows our problems. He knows our hurts. He knows our battles in our mind, in our heart, in our body. He knows them all. Oh, and I believe the Lord wants us to take him there. Hallelujah. I said the Lord wants us to take him there. And I tell you, if he wanted to heal your body, he can do it with just the snap of his fingers. If he wanted to deliver you, he could just snap his finger. Oh, and heal you. Oh, but can I tell you, sometime he's waiting for the effort on the Christian's part. He's waiting for the effort on you and I's part to take him to that place. Oh, where he lay. Oh, to you. Oh, the Bible says Jesus shows out to the grave. He says, take away the stone. Get that stone out of here. They begin to roll that stone. And now they see this dead body for 4 days. He's been laying there. And we know the shortest verse of the Bible. Jesus wept. Oh, how he loved this man. The Jews begin to say, man, oh, how he loved Lazarus. Can I tell you this morning? Jesus, the Bible said, he was there. He's seeing his friend that has been dead for 4 days, laying in that tomb. Oh, the Bible says Jesus cried with a loud voice. He said, Lazarus, come forth. He said, Lazarus, come forth. And you know, the Bible says he that was dead came forth. Spirit. calling your name.
Yes, he is.
I said he's calling your name. Hallelujah. Oh, let me just be honest with you. And I tell you, sometimes in church, we get a little scared. Sometimes during preaching. Sometimes in church, we get a little nervous. And I tell you, that's not normal. That's the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I said, that's the Holy Ghost. I mean, the Holy Ghost, he's trying to draw sinners unto a holy God. He's trying to draw those that are lost into a relationship, in a love relationship with Jesus. Oh, I've seen some people there in church, and I mean, they're nervous. Oh, they're shaking, they're nervous. Man, they're just sitting there. I've seen it even while I've been preaching. I've seen it while others have been preaching. I've seen it while sitting in the crowd myself. Man, I've seen them get nervous. Have you ever got nervous in church before? Have you noticed the Holy Ghost drawing you? Pastors in Kaiser, Oregon. We went and preached for him last year. He grew up in Keys, California. Anybody know where Keys is? Praise the Lord. You're not missing much. Hallelujah. Keys, California. It's by Modesto, really, about 5 miles from Modesto. It's a very drug-infested neighborhood, drug-infested town. This guy, he grew up in it. I mean, this guy was a drug addict. A crackhead. You know what? One day, him and his cousin, they went to this church to pick up their grandmother. Their grandmother was saved. You know what? It was a revival service. Oh, one of the weekdays. Oh, one of those nights that him and his cousin, they got high. Oh, they're high out of their mind. And they said, man, we got to go pick up grandma from church. Hallelujah. Oh, so what happened? You know what? They sat in the parking lot. And they could hear the preacher preaching. Oh, in that church. They could hear the evangelist yelling and shouting. Oh, and jumping around and dancing. Well, so you know what? They just said, why don't we just go in and check it out? Hallelujah. Oh, so they went there and they sat on the back row. They're there and they're sitting, you know what? Oh, they think they're laughing. You know, they're high out of their mind. I'm not going to ask who's ever been high here. Praise the Lord. Oh, man, they're high out of their mind. Oh, they're just sitting there. Oh, that preacher, he begins to preach. Oh, brother. Oh, this pastor, he said, you know, that preacher, he was jumping on one leg all the way down the aisle, telling you need to get saved. You need to get saved. Oh, the Holy Ghost began to move on those boys. His cousin, he said, you know what? He said, this preacher knows what we did. This preacher knows that we got high. And this pastor, he slapped his cousin. He said, no, he don't know. That's just what preachers do. They just try to draw out every sin out of you. They just try to call everything out. He said, no, man, I think they do. Oh, man, that evangelist, he kept preaching. Oh, doing the work of God. Holy Ghost was coming by, convicting those boys. You know what? Oh, that preacher, he came all the way back down to the last row. And he pointed his fingers at those boys. And he said, you know what? Oh, shooting heroin in your veins is like shooting the devil inside of your body. And that pastor, he stood up, he looked at his cousin, he said, this preacher does know what we did. Let's get out of here. Hallelujah. Oh, they got out of there. Oh, but can I tell you, when the Holy Ghost moves, huh? I said, when the Holy Ghost moves, you'll never forget it. I said, when the Holy Ghost moves, you'll never forget it. But oh, I mean, on this man. Oh, one day he came to an altar and cried out to God. And now he is pastoring a church where he's helping others. Yeah. Where he's helping others, people. Oh, come to a knowledge of Jesus Christ. Come to him. He's calling your name today. Oh, I said he's calling your name today. Oh, just as he cried to his friend that day, Lazarus, come forth. He's calling out your name today. Come forth, sinner. Yeah. You don't have to be dead any longer.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. He's calling.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's calling.
Thank
your name. Hallelujah. Said he's calling your name this morning.
Yes, yes.
I tell you, aren't you glad he's not just talking to sinners?
Oh, thank God, man.
Let me tell you.
Thank God.
Oh, saint of God, he's calling your name this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, I said he's calling your name this morning. I'm glad he's calling my name this morning. See, you know what? If my relationship with God was only about my experience that I had, at salvation, and that was the whole entire relationship, it wouldn't be much of a relationship. It would just be based on one day of a relationship rather than a lifetime. Living with Him and serving Him. But can I tell you, I'm glad that I had that experience, but I'm also glad that He still calls my name. Hallelujah. I'm glad that He's there every step of the way. And He's saying, come forth. I said, He's saying, come forth. I said, He's saying, come forth. And the Bible says, he that was dead came forth. Oh, Lazarus, he had been dead for 4 days. Oh, but Jesus called His name.
God. He called His name. Amen.
I got news for you today. He's talking loud enough for you to hear Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Have you ever Jew around that graveyard, every Jew around that tomb could hear Jesus saying, Lazarus, come forth. Hallelujah. And I tell you, sinners, they hear the voice of God. And I tell you, Christians, we hear the voice of God. He's calling our name this morning. Oh, He's saying, come forth. Oh, you know what coming forth means? It means getting out of that grave. I said it means getting out of that grave. And I tell you, the sad thing is this world, it's headed to hell very fast. But it seems like when the church should be on fire for God, because how many believe we're living in the last days? I believe Jesus is coming back. With all my heart, I believe He's coming back after a church that's without spot or wrinkle. Coming after a church, that is like the beginning of the book of Acts. Coming after a church that's on fire for God. It seems like there's a whole lot of church people. They're living inside of that tomb. They're living inside of that grave. Many, many times. Oh, on Lazarus. I've preached many, many times. And the thing, that always sticks out to me is this next verse here in 44. And he that was dead came forth. Having Lazarus is not backslidden. Lazarus, he's not dead anymore, but life is in him. He heard the voice of God. Yeah. Oh, I read one commentary where they said, you know what? Jesus, He talked loud enough that Lazarus could even hear Him in paradise. Hallelujah. Jesus talked loud enough, cried His name out. They begin to expound on that. They begin to say, you know what? Lazarus is probably talking amongst the saints of God. He's probably there with Isaiah. Isaiah, I've seen the Lord. He's probably talking to Abraham. See, you know what, Abraham? Remember when you were looking for a city who's come forth. Hallelujah. Oh, come forth. Lord. Aren't you glad that Jesus, He still calls? I said, aren't you glad that Jesus, He still calls? Glory to God. I'm glad that He still calls. He'll call those Christians. Can you imagine this? Oh, man. Here we are. Cain and Abel. Oh, you find they're both there, or one of them's there in paradise, man. And then all of a sudden another one comes named Abraham. All of a sudden another one comes named Noah. And they just begin gathering up. The Bible says in the New Testament they were known as the prisoners of hope. Hallelujah. The prisoners of hope. I'm talking about prisoners here in shackles and chains. Oh, but they were in this place called paradise. Yeah. Oh, they're all gathering there. They're all waiting for the Savior to come. All waiting there for the Savior to come. And they begin to expound on each other, probably telling each other what's going on. Has the Savior come? Oh, has the seed of Abraham come? Oh, to deliver. Hallelujah. Oh, and then finally one day, oh, they could hear a voice. I said they could hear a voice. Oh, as the Lamb of God was slain. The Lamb of God was slain on Calvary's cross. And I feel when He resurrected, hallelujah. At that time, those prisoners of hope had already been broke free. Hallelujah. I said those prisoners of hope had already been broke free. I'm telling you today, I'm not trying to be over our head. I'm really not. I'm trying to get this across to us today. Christian, He's calling our day. He's saying, don't stay in the grave. He's saying, get up and go for it.
Yes, yes, amen.
I love verse 44, and I preached on it many, many times. But verse 44, it always stands out to me. He was bound by grave clothes. Yes. So many Christians are bound by the things of this old life.
Yeah. Come on.
Bound by the things of this world. Yeah. Huh? Until Lazarus, he had no business with grave clothes on anymore because he was alive.
Hallelujah.
And I tell you, Christian, you have no business going out in this world. Why? Because we have life in us.
Hallelujah.
I said we have life in us. And I see our mouth should talk differently than the world.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. I said our mouth should talk differently than this world. And I tell you the things that we watch. Are you saying I can't watch anything? No, I'm not saying that. But I'm saying we need to put up a guard in our eyes. We need to put up a guard in our life. I'm not going to watch the old things that I used to watch. Bound by great clothes, had no business with them on anymore. Why? Because he had life. Oh, praise the Lord. He was bound by his hands. And I see there's a lot of Christians, they're bound by their head. There's a lot of Christians, they don't know how to worship God anymore. They don't have to, they don't know how to lift up his name anymore. And I see he's trying to loose you today. He's calling out your name today. I said he's calling out your name today. He ain't just talking to the sinner. He's talking to the church today. And he inhabits, or he comes in and dwells. He comes down. Oh, and is in the presence of his people.
Yes.
When they begin to worship him, I got news for you today. We can shout and we can clap and we can yell all out of set a baseball game or at a basketball game or at a Raiders football game. But I got news for you today. Oh, he's more worthy than the Raiders anymore. Preachers are mean. He's calling your name.
That's it. He's calling.
He's calling your name.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
See, sometimes in church when we start to feel bad, that's a good sign.
That's right.
Amen. So that's a good sign.
Yes, it is.
So you know, I'm not bringing conviction on you.
Right.
I'm just a mouthpiece for God right now.
That's right. Amen. That's it.
The Holy Ghost, He'll start to convict. Huh?
Oh, yes, He is. Yes.
You ever seen those people in church there? I mean, their arms are shaking. Huh? They're off the call. You feel me? They're just doing this. Huh? They're just nervous. Huh? They're nervous. He's calling you this morning.
Yes.
He's calling you this morning. Hallelujah. I said he's calling you this morning. Oh, and it's a good thing when you begin to get a little nervous. You know what? How many of God wouldn't convict anybody? Oh, if they weren't convicted. Hallelujah. And I tell you, God wouldn't convict anybody if they were already destined to go to hell.
He's called.
Yes.
Believe he's called.
Amen.
He's
He's waiting for you to respond.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's waiting for you to respond. Hallelujah. You ever got a call on your cell phone? And you know there's a green button and then there's a red button? Have you ever saw who was calling and you clicked the red button? Praise the Lord.
Come on.
Oh, Pastor Williams calling. Praise the Lord. He's calling.
Yeah.
Don't reject him today. Don't decline him today. He's calling you.
Yes.
He's calling. Have you ever faked him before? You got a call from somebody and you let it ring for a little bit. So you knew, so they would think that it didn't go straight to voicemail. How many know what I'm talking about? Hallelujah. You let it ring for a little bit. I tell you, he's talking and he's talking and he's calling and he's calling. Don't let it ring any longer. Pick it up. Hallelujah. Hit the green button this morning. Say, God, I hear your voice. You're calling me to a higher goal. You're calling me to grow closer. You're calling me, oh, to live for you in a deeper and a richer way. Calling me. Have you lift up your hand this morning? Say, Brother Aaron, I believe he's calling me. I believe he's calling me. God sees those hands. Hallelujah. I believe he's calling me. Have you lift up your hand? Say, you know what? I'm not completely backslid, but I know he's calling me. I'm part of the church. I know he's calling me. Hallelujah. Have you lift up your hands today? Say, you know what? I want to go to a higher walk. I want to go to a closer walk with you. He's calling you. I said he's calling you. Don't decline it today. Don't ignore it today. He's calling you. Let's come.
Come.